Hey everyone, in the video I uploaded on November 10th, I mentioned that the creator of AutoStakkert, Emil Kraaikamp, was announced that he was working on releasing a beta version of AutoStakkert 4, and the very next day on November 11th, he did just that. And as a fan of the application, I was very excited to download it and try it as soon as possible, but it took me 3 days to actually try and get to it. And I thought I'd do a really quick demo of the interface. It looks very similar to what we are using, but I was more interested to see if it was any faster, if it handled memory usage a little bit better than AutoStakkert 3, even if it did everything else the exact same way. So you can find this on autostakkert.com. This is the post he had on November 11, 2023. The last post was on August 8, 2020, where he posted a link to a demo he did on his very first version of AutoStakkert 4 more than 3 years ago. So it is a long time coming. We know that Emil is super busy, and we are all thankful for all the work that he's done on this application, and I am very excited to try this out. So you can download it here. The current version is 4.0.3. It's still an early beta version, so there are still bugs. You can report them to Emil if you find them. I found a couple. There's a Cloudy Nice thread where everyone is just posting what they're finding. It's been super helpful to find workarounds and to see what others are experiencing. I have AutoStakkert 4 downloaded, and I'm already out of date. 4.0.2 is what I have. 4.0.3 is here. If you look at the change notes, there hasn't been enough changes for me to update it right now. I'll do that after I'm done with this video. And like I said, I wanted to do a test of the speed and to see if it worked any better than AutoStakkert 3. That's my most important part. So I did run through my workflow in AutoStakkert 3. I took some screenshots that I'll show you as I'm running through the various steps of this, but I thought I'd also show you the UI and the differences that I noticed. And I'm sure as the bugs get fixed, this will just feel a lot better over the coming months, maybe years, depending on how long it takes, Emil. So, AutoStakkert 4. So I'm just going to load one of the videos I took on Saturday as part of my live stream. So this is just one of those videos. And this is what it looks like. You'll notice that as soon as we load the image, the first difference is that there's a histogram here. It's a little line graph histogram. It looks pretty cool, and it does let you know that, you know, your data isn't being clipped anywhere. So if this histogram is like all the way over to here and you couldn't see the bottom, you'd know that your data was clipped. You can turn it off with this checkbox. It also has a couple more brightness options, so you can go darker, which you couldn't do in AutoStakkert 3. You can go to brightness square root, which makes it a little bit better. You couldn't do that in AutoStakkert 3 either. And then it goes all the way up to 16. I think in AutoStakkert 3 it goes up to 256, which you don't really need, not for the sun at least. But we'll keep it at 1. In this window, this looks pretty much the same, the UI. The only thing is that if I hover over this window, this thing gets pushed to the back, like the image stabilization is the same, except when you click on surface, we have this other option that says find anchor. So what this will do is, if you're batch processing, this I think is useful. It will find an automatic anchor point for you. And there's a bug around this where if you're doing a batch process, it'll stack, but it won't save the stack. So if you have 10 videos that you wanna process and stack, it'll analyze. It'll stack, but then when you go to check to see if it actually stacked, you'll find no file. So that's the only bug here. Planet is the same. It uses, you know, center of gravity for alignment, for analyzing, and that's what I'll use for this video because the sun kind of looks like a planet. If you have sky all around the object, you can use the planetary stabilization method. The quality estimator is now automatic. Not that we ever had to really go away from the default in AutoStakkert 3, but this is super useful. So it just does it all for you. And then we'll click on analyze, and then we'll take a look at how long the analysis took, and then we'll compare it to what AutoStakkert 3 had. All right, so that's done, and I have this screenshot here from AutoStakkert 3 on the exact same file. And as you can see, the analysis took 80.1 seconds, and this took 60.8 seconds. This is my second time running this. The first time it took less than 50 seconds, which was pretty impressive. I don't know why it's slower this time, but that's quite all right. And the quality graph, you can see it looks the same, and it works really well. So it's already a lot better. It's already 25% faster than it was here, which can save you a lot of time if you're processing a huge video file or you're doing a batch process. So 25% time is quite significant. So the one thing, if you look at the two UIs, you'll notice is that this one, there's a checkbox here. And if you hover over it, it is the detect system. So what this does is, so it connects you to another application called detect that can detect surface impacts on like Jupiter, the moon, or Saturn, or anywhere. I don't have that installed, but you can read up on detect and see how that works. In the demo that Emil did in August 2020, he did go a little bit over how that works, and it's really interesting. All right, the next step we need to do is create some alignment points here, and I already set it to like 200 alignment points. We're using multi-scale, and then I'll do place AP grid, and this should take a couple of seconds. All right, the alignment points have been placed, and then the next thing we can do is stack. But you can see that the, if I pull over the screenshot once more, you can see that the options are pretty much the same between the 3 and 4. The output options in AutoStakkert 4 is slightly different because now you can include the detect system here, where you can automate using that right after each batch process. But everything else is pretty much the same. And before I click on stack, I mentioned that the memory usage in AutoStakkert 3 was always a problem for me. It always like held on to the RAM. Here in AutoStakkert 4, I realized that after you analyze, it does hold on to some of the RAM. So if I pull over my task manager, I'm just going to show you that part, you'll see that it is using about 9.5 gigs of RAM. And when I'll pull it over again when it's running the stack, we'll notice, we'll see that it is using a lot more processing power and RAM, but after it finishes stacking, it'll actually get rid of that RAM usage, which is great, where AutoStakkert 3 did not. So let's click on stack. So while that's stacking, I'll pull this over. You'll see that it is using like 67% of my cores. I'm using, you know, 8 threads, which is it's a quad core CPU with another 4 threads, i7 processor, and it's using 10 gigs of RAM or so. And almost immediately after it finishes, it should get rid of, it should release the RAM for me to use elsewhere. So just leave this here and see how long that takes. All right, so this completed, and there's a skip in this because I use OBS to record my screen, and it was also using up a lot of CPU and RAM, and it didn't like working with AutoStakkert, so it ended up slowing things down. So I closed my recording, and then I re-recorded it, and you can see the new values here. So I re-ran this, so you can see the analysis is much faster, and everything else is much faster. And I'll bring up a screenshot I took of a completed stack in AutoStakkert 3, and you can see that the analysis took 80 seconds here. In my first run, it took about 60 seconds. My second run is 46 seconds, much faster. And the reference frames, alignment, stacking, map analysis, you can see the differences here. The alignment is much faster. Stacking seems to be just a tiny bit faster, but stacking never took that long anyway. Same thing with the map analysis and map recombination. And I did add them up. It's total of 86 seconds, not counting the analysis, 86.1 seconds in AutoStakkert 3. And in AutoStakkert 4, it's 63.1 seconds. So the difference is only about 23 seconds. It doesn't sound like a lot, but if you're doing batch stacking, it could save you a ton of time, depending on how many stacks you have. And it'll also save you more time the larger your video files are that you're trying to process. So the engine used in AutoStakkert 4 is definitely much faster, and this is proof here. And I also mentioned that you can see the memory usage here is 1.8 gigs. So I've had this running for a couple of hours now because I have to go away and do something. And it did, you know, it let go of the RAM like before it even like finished stacking. And that was available for my other software to use. And this is a screenshot of a task manager on AutoStakkert 3. This is while it's running, so it did use my CPU at 90% and about 13 gigs. And about 15 minutes after it was done, you know, it wasn't using CPU anymore, but you can see the memory, it like never really let it go, and it was continuing to add on. So this was 15 minutes in. So one of the problems I had with AutoStakkert 3 is when I ran it overnight, and it would just hold on to that RAM until I closed AutoStakkert. And AutoStakkert 4 does much better with memory management. And I think the fix in AutoStakkert 3 is to just go to memory usage and do no buffering, but adaptive buffering is faster, and I think it's better according to Emil. So just gonna do what he says. And now we'll look at the final results. So I have this stack from AS3, and this is AS4. So if I open them up here, You'll see that there is like no difference as I go back and forth. So the quality estimator, or you know, the automatic quality estimator, and the way it stacks is still the same between the two. There's probably some slight improvements on the back end that I'm not aware of, but it looks great still, and I can process this in IMPPG and Photoshop when I'm ready. So this is just a first look at AutoStakkert 4. I'm really excited to see what the coming weeks and months bring to this application. It already works really well. I've done batching with this already. If you do batching on the sun, if you can see the full disk of the sun, and you select planet, and then you do batching, it does save the batched stack files. The only problem you'll have, as I said, is if you do surface, you click on find anchor, and you try and do it using this workflow here, which you'd probably do if you're using like a Barlow or you're zoomed into the sun, where you're not catching the whole disk and you don't have sky all around the disk. So in that case, you may want to stick with AutoStakkert 3. For now, I think, I know I said that I'll probably stick with AutoStakkert 3, but I think I'll keep using AutoStakkert 4, see if I can find bugs and report them when I can. And otherwise, I'm just going to keep on using this. And maybe once when more enhancements and more bug fixes are introduced to AS4, I'll do more videos later on in the future. But from now on, I think when I do a live stream of the sun or the moon or the planets and I do a live stack, I'll probably use AutoStakkert 4 just to get used to it and also be a little bit QA for Emil and whoever else he may have working on this application. AutoStakkert 4, yay! Clear skies.